First of all, I wanted to feel reasonably confident that I knew what I was talking about. In private, I've liked learning and talking about physics ever since I was a student. In fact, talking about the subject as soon as one has a general idea of the notions and the language is a great way to learn things, since more experienced people can then correct your misconceptions, and you really learn through that process. But referring to physics in my research, or organizing public activities surrounding physics, is claiming a good deal more competence than might be required for conversations, so that took longer. The fact that the number theory community tends to be a pretty tough-minded crowd was probably part of the reason for my silence. They're not easily impressed by ideas unless you show that you can do something definite with them. So I needed to have theorems, results, some pretty concrete directions before admitting that physics was an important part of my thinking. I sometimes like to compare theorems and definite results to money in the bank. Then, when you're just describing ideas and general philosophy, you're using that money, maybe even going into debt. So then you need to get back to proving theorems. I should stress that I think this kind of skepticism on the part of the community is a good thing overall. Meeting the challenge of skeptics is definitely an important part of organizing one's thoughts, thereby making them more precise and useful, even if it's difficult sometimes. Perhaps a more weighty aspect of the decision to admit the influence of physics openly now is a certain sense of scientific obligation. To put it in slightly grandiose terms, it's clear we're at a place in scientific history where the interplay of ideas between physics and number theory is quite important. And young people, especially energetic young people, should be paying attention to it. There are many indications, such as the work on motives and Feynman diagrams, old and new work on conformal field theory and modular forms, arithmetic aspects of Chern-Simons theory, S-duality and the Langlands program, and many, many others. I feel strongly that the interface has important insight to offer to people working in arithmetic geometry, but also to people working in fundamental physics, especially quantum field theory and strings. Even if I personally say some foolish things while advertising the connections, I feel like I shouldn't be hiding from a serious discourse in private as well as in public.